Super good to see you guys here. Welcome to another episode of Robitech. We are here checking out the brand new Corsair 3500X case. We're gonna be showing the insides, the outsides. So let's talk about what we're putting inside of it. We're gonna be using the Ryzen 7 7800X 3D. For the motherboard for this one, we're using the MSI B650 Carbon Wi-Fi. For our storage, we're going Corsair here because it's a Corsair build. So we're gonna use the Vengeance RAM. This is DDR5, 32 gigs of 6,000 mega transfer RAM. And then I like these as well. This is the MP600 Pro NH. It's a 2 terabyte NVMe drive. So it should have plenty of room for anything that you wanna do, from like putting in like 1/3 of COD or half of Flight Sim. For our cooler, giving IQ Link. So we're actually gonna be using the IQ Link H150i. Really like this cooler. But we're gonna play with new fans today. So brand new fans from the folks over at Corsair. Still IQ Link, but we're gonna use their LX120 RGBs instead of the QX120s that are included with this. So we'll run thermals and stuff like that, see how this goes. By the way, the magnets in this are so strong. Check this out. Like, they're so strong, they get felt through the box. So we got 9 of these fans to throw inside of the case, which is fun. Here we go. Yeah, so now, like, look at this. It's like you can have like a train of these things. So we're gonna be playing with their LX120, showing those off. And no surprise, my favorite kind of PSU, which I know drives our techs mad a little bit nuts. This is the Tough Gaming 850 watt power supply. The GeForce RTX 4070 Super from PNY. These guys have just got finished picking up Kingpin. We did a whole video on the PNY series, so if you want to check those out. And this is just such a great cost card. And at the same time, this whole build that you guys are going to see here is $2,200. So nicely priced from that perspective. And then, of course, we also have some cable extensions to keep things clean. Let's start with putting our CPU in. We like to zoom way in for that. Look at the zoom, guys. So let's go ahead and put our M.2 in here. So on the board, it has a ton, actually. It's actually pretty good. There you go. Look at that. I mean, you got a lot of inputs on the back of this board. Good for content creators and stuff like that. Really beefy board, yeah. Okay, here we go, guys. Testing our clicks here. That was at 97.1. Okay, here we go. That was 97.6. What did we say? Oh, it wasn't anywhere near 100. Okay, here we go. Motherboard is pretty much ready. This is an interesting case from Corsair. So this right here is the Corsair 3500X. It's got kind of a standard shroud. It is BTF compatible, which all of their stuff kind of is. The one thing I do like about having these holes on standard builds, which is what we're gonna put in today, is that it does make it really easy to slip and hide cables. The version that we have here is the ARGB version, but unfortunately, we're gonna remove all of these and go with IQ Link. So we're gonna be putting two here over the PSU and then the rest here. So let's go and remove our fans really quick. The case have any immediate red flags? Not so far. Okay, guys, taking out all of these. Look at how many cables we get rid of with just this. All those cables gone. That was like the majority of the cables. Like, look at what I have left of cables. There's like 5. Okay, so here's these fans. I've not used them before. These ridiculous screws I love so much. Love these screws. Okay, here we go. So we're gonna do intake on the side. And you know, it's funny, because like I get excited about using the screws because of just how easy they are. This thing is like basically holding. Wow, that was fast. Okay, awesome. Okay guys, 3 fans in, 35, a gajillion more to go. Let's put our other 2 in. This one I'm gonna have to use those special screws, I think. You guys wanna see magic? Here we go. Magic time, you guys ready? And then you rub them together and then, so much magic. Magic. All right, there we go, connected. Get our Mobo in. This is gonna look sweet in here. We got our 3 fans in already. Okay, so we got motherboard in. Let's go ahead and hook up our front panel connectors now. Not a lot of cables to run through here. So USB 3.2 right here. There we go. And then we grab our USB-C. That's gonna go up here. Then we got our front panel. That's gonna go right here. And this is our fourth connection right here. There is our HD audio, and then I'm gonna grab this. This one is gonna be for our IQ Link Hub. So we're gonna go ahead and route that down to USB-C, which is over here. So that'll take care of that. So there are all of our connections ready. So let's go ahead and pop this down. There we go. Okay, so all of our front panel connections are now hooked up. Now, that's all done. Those all look really good there. Okay, let's put our rear fan in. Okay, so that's all ready. That's how it looks so far, right? Which I think looks really good. Let's get our AIO installed. I have to say, this little IQ Link nub here, this nub hole, so cool. Really like this. Okay, let's get our AIO put together, because we're not gonna use the QX120 fans. We're gonna use the new LS120 fans. LX120, I mean, sorry. There we go. And now, okay, those are all in. So now we have our rear fan hooked up. Now we're gonna throw our two CPU EPS connectors up here. There we go. Now we can put this in. Okay, there we go. There we go. Okay, fans are all in, all hooked up. They're all daisy chained. Now all we gotta do is deal with this little bad boy. The build looks like this now, guys. Just need to install our CPU fan header. After this, we just basically got to put in our GPU and our PSU. IQ Link, the PSU, like all of these things together just make for a really fast, smooth build experience. Very nice, thin 4070, super. The good thing about this is that there's not gonna be any sag or anything like that. Ugh. Okay, last bit, guys. Last little tiny bit of this build. Okay, let's grab our PSU, which is one of my favorites. Tough Gaming Gold. It's got super malleable cables, which always makes me happy. Okay, so now the key thing here is just to get these cable managed. There we go. Okay, all the cable management done is done, guys. There is our build, all done. Nice and clean, very easy to cable manage, which is nice. Let's get the case back together. Looks good. All right, here we go, guys. 3, 2, 1. Jeez. Let's just take a look at our temps here real quick, guys. Right now, 51 degrees. Starting our multi-core. Fans popped up right at 80. Seems to be sitting, we might get into the mid 80s, but I mean, all in all, like it's gonna be pretty close to 83, 84. Does a pretty good job of getting it back down. It seems to be sticking at 83, so I don't think we're gonna have any problems with the temps. And there we go. Okay, guys, let's take a look at a little Cyberpunk and then we'll be good here. And there you go, 68, 67, 68 on the CPU, 62, 63. On your GPU, right? And there we go, guys. 92.64 frames per second at 1440p with DLSS on. See, temps are not an issue or anything like that, and that is it. And the build looks really good, which is nice. Thank you so much for joining me, and we'll see you guys on the next episode. Bye, YouTube.